मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, होप एवरीथिंग इज़ वेल एंड सो डू आई. भावना देसाई, योर साइंस टीचर इज़ विद यू विद द लेसन नंबर 7, सॉरी विद द लेसन नंबर 5. वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर लेसन विद एक्टिविटी नंबर 7. टेक अ मिक्सचर ऑफ सैंड एंड सॉल्ट. हाउ विल वी सेपरेट दिस? वी ऑलरेडी सॉ that hand picking would not be able or practical method for separating this. As you know children, hand picking, when the components are little bit big, at that time only we can use hand picking. But to separate mixture of salt and sand is not possible with the method of hand picking. So how we will do it? Now let us see further. Keep this mixture in a beaker and add some water to it. Leave the beaker aside for some time. Do you see the sand setting down at the bottom? First, we will prepare a mixture of salt and sand, and we'll have one beaker. In beaker, we'll add the mixture of salt and sand, and with that, we will add some water also in it. Now we have to keep this mixture aside for some time. Do you find something else? Yes, we can see that the sand mixture is settling at the bottom. The sand can be separated by decantation or filtration. What does the decanted liquid contain? Do you think this water contains the salt which was there in the mixture at the beginning? Means in the water, whether salt is present or not, that they are asking. Now we need to separate salt and water from the decanted liquid. Transfer this liquid to a kettle and close its lid. As you know, sand, it is already settled down, so it has been separated. But how to separate salt from water? That is the further procedure that we are doing. So the mixture of water with salt, we will transfer that to a kettle. And remember that the kettle, there should be a lid on a kettle. First pour that liquid in a kettle and close it with a lid. Heat the kettle for some time. Do you notice steam coming out from the spout of the kettle? Take a metal plate with some ice on it. Hold the plate just above the spout of the kettle as shown in figure number 5.13. What do you observe? Let all the water in the kettle boil off. When the steam comes in contact with the metal plate cooled with ice, it condenses and forms liquid water. The water drops that you observe following from the plate were due to condensation of steam. The process of conversion of water vapor into liquid form is called condensation. Again, I will repeat, the process of condensation of water vapor into its liquid form is called condensation. Before going further, I will show you the picture. See, you can see here, there is a kettle and it has lid. We have already poured water in this, and here we have started heating. Once you will start heating, after a few seconds, water vapor or steam will come out from the kettle spout. Then what we told you, what we saw, that we will have one iron plate or one metal plate, and on that we will keep some ice. Once the steam will hit on this plate, due to this ice, the steam will convert into a liquid. You can see the droplet of liquid is going down in a beaker. The process of वेपर कंडेंसिंग आफ्टर कंडेंसिंग चेंजिंग इनटू लिक्विड इज कॉल्ड कंडेंसेशन. डिड यू एवर सी वाटर ड्रॉप्स कंडेंस अंडर अ प्लेट दैट हैज बीन यूज्ड टू कवर अ वेसल कंटेनिंग मिल्क दैट हैज जस्ट बीन बॉइल्ड. दिस इज अ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल. चिल्ड्रन, हैव यू सीन व्हेन योर मम्मा शी इज बॉइलिंग मिल्क and after boiling it she is keeping aside the milk and covering that milk vessel with a lid. After some time if you'll open that lid you will find some drops of water on the lid. That is once the steam will touch the plate or the once the steam will touch the plate it will start condensing or it will be cooled down and after cooling down it will change into again a water. After all the water has evaporated, what is left behind in the kettle? As we boil the kettle, the water which was converted into vapor, it has come out and something is left in the kettle. Only water started boiling and after boiling it changed into vapor and again after a condensation it became water. So all the water we removed from the mixture. Now something is left in the kettle. We have thus separated salt, sand and water using processes of decantation, filtration, evaporation and condensation. These are the four processes we did to separate salt, water and sand. We use four methods to separate these three components. First is decantation, second filtration, third is evaporation and fourth is condensation. Pehli faced a problem while recovering salt mixed with sand. She has mixed a packet of salt in a small amount of sand. Pehli, what she did, she took very small amount of water and she added one full packet of salt. Now she is finding some difficulty. What is that? That we will see now. She then tried the method of suggested in activity 7 to remove the salt she found. However, that she could recover only a small part of salt that she has taken. What could have gone wrong? Means she did all this decantation, then filtration, evaporation, all the methods she applied, but the situation was that she took very little water and one full packet of salt, and now she is finding difficulty because while doing all this process she got very less salt. She added a full packet, but while gaining she got very less salt. So what was wrong? That we will see in the next session. Till then, bye bye, see you.